hier!
Arre, Ben!
Maybe we got some color here. Come on.
You picked the spot and dug. And you couldn't know if the work was wasted until you separated the gold from the dirt. Panning, simple and thorough, was one way of washing away the worthless lighter minerals. The gold particles, being heavier, would sink to the bottom of the pan. The gold was usually found in the form of dust or flakes. You might get a pinch or so in each pan, and you could wash 50 pans a day if your back held out and if the icy water didn't cripple your hands and legs. Panning was always used to try out a new prospect, but the miners learned from experience how to handle more dirt by other means. A device called a cradle could be knocked together out of available materials in a few hours. The rocking action and the flow of water washed the pay dirt down through the hopper. The heavy particles of gold were caught by ripple bars, cleats set crosswise in the bottom of a trough. If you had a river or a creek nearby and could spend $10 a board for dressed lumber, you could rig a system to carry water to the diggings. Then you could build a long tom, actually an oversized cradle that didn't need rocking. You soaked the dirt and broke it up by hand, and the mixture of dirt, gold, and water flowed out the end of the tom. The heavy gold particles were caught behind ripple bars and would stay there until the box was drained and emptied at the end of the day. One way or the other, it all boiled down to the backbreaking job of moving dirt from sunup to sundown, 6 days a week.
Okay, Ben, dinner up. We're all set, boys.
Some men didn't live to spend the gold they'd worked so hard to get. Fights claimed a few, accidents in the mines took more, and disease, a natural outcome of the makeshift life of the camps, took most of all.
Easy as it, boys.
Day by day, month by month, a miner watched his takings grow. A few pokes of glistening dust would change a man's life. Maybe you couldn't scoop up gold by the hatful, but there was enough to keep a man thinking he'd go home rich. The problem was how to get more. The dream was to discover an untouched pocket of gold, and well into the 1850s, it was a dream that could come true.
Back east and lay the east for both of us. Maybe a spree in Frisco on the way.
Well, come on, let's dig it out.
A few men did get rich, but most of the miners, still poor and a few years older, would have to make a fresh start. They'd farm or take jobs, marry and raise families. The gold adventure that brought over 200,000 people to California had ended. But the high hopes and raw energy remained. With luck, the miners would strike it rich some other way in the new West they'd helped create.
Like a crowd, black gold in a white flag, won't you fill up the tank?
Yours, this side's mine.